ni studio indie pop. So, management label Yuna KS.
Selamat datang ke Indie Pop.
For the past year, what we've really been doing is just trying to just to do a couple things. You know, the first thing is really trying to you know, develop Yuna's music. That's been our main goal first and foremost, is to, you know, get her in with producers and help give Yuna like the tools necessary to you know, really materialize her vision for her music. So it's, you know, it's pretty simple. We're just trying to get her in front of as many people as possible, and whether that be, you know, through her going on tour, you know, working with MTV. I think the songs that she's making are really amazing, and she has a unique voice, and I think people are becoming familiar with her. We've got her working with a bunch of great people, with Dre, Chris Braid, Pharrell, and it's been really successful. You know, we recorded an awesome album, and that's kind of what we set out to do.
I love different music, and when I met Yuna and heard some of the things that she had done, I'm like listening to the music and I'm like looking at her like, how, what is this? And that is that special thing when you meet somebody and you hear something that's like completely different than what you expect, and every time they sing a note, you're just locked in. And without further ado, I would love for her to come to the stage and play for you guys so you can see what we've been seeing. This is Yuna.
Looking for something amazing. It's almost like I've been stargazing.
Bila saya diberi tahu saya akan bekerja dengan Pharrell, saya macam make sure dulu kejap. Okay, kerja dengan Pharrell. Ni Pharrell mana ni ya? Saya macam yang kata Pharrell Williams lah. Macam, oh, Pharrell Williams. Dalam hati macam tu lah, macam Pharrell. Tapi macam cool je kan, macam oh okay, oh Pharrell, oh yeah, I'm a fan of his music.
All my life, my dreams just seem so far away, and now it's like they're here to stay.
Time tu saya ingat lagi saya pergi Miami, saya naik flight. I was on the flight alone, kan? Saya seorang je fly ke Miami. And sebab manager saya dah tunggu dekat Miami, saya rasa cawush, nak jumpa Pharrell, takutnya. And then bila sampai je Miami, terus pergi studio Pharrell. Dia memang baik, and dia ajak tangkap gambar, dia tangkap gambar. You know, kita rasa selesa dengan dia. Kita rasa macam we are at the same level, even though saya sangat-sangat baru. And even though Pharrell Williams tu di dekat sini kan, dalam apa kerja dia, saya dekat sini, tapi dalam studio tu dia bawa sama level macam tu. So senanglah bekerja dengan dia, and from that level we just work towards what we want. Eh? Ada keserasian dekat situ, and kita orang dapat menghasilkan lagu yang cool lah, lagu pop yang dia kata genre tu macam lush pop je.
Okay, ni kamera Canon EOS 7D. Salah satu feature yang saya suka tentang kamera ni is the burst mode yang membolehkan kita tangkap gambar 8 frames per second. Biasanya feature ni akan digunakan oleh fotografer profesional yang tangkap gambar sukan, contohnya bola ataupun lompat tinggi, lompat jauh. Tapi kalau saya akan tangkap gambar benda-benda yang simple je. Contohnya, gambar kawan saya melompat. We'll be right back.
kita nak pergi tepi pantai. Tapi nak pergi tepi pantai tu sangat jauh daripada downtown and kita orang tak ada kereta. So, kita orang kena naik bas. Nak naik bas pergi Venice adalah dalam masa 2 tahun setengah. Sangat lama naik bas. Kita orang ambil masa sejam 15 minit macam tu lah. Sejam 15 minit nak sampai daripada downtown LA to Venice.
Sekarang berada di Venice Beach. So, as you can see, kat situ banyak-banyak kedai and okay, kita orang agak awal lah. Sekarang ni pukul 1:30.
So, bila sampai Venice tu macam wow, best. And bawa Wawa jalan-jalan dekat tepi tu. And Venice, dia sangat happening. Best lah. Dan hari tu pun, it was a beautiful day. Macam tak sejuk, tak mendung.
Yuna photo play.
Everything is always macam apa, ceria lah. Macam everyday mesti ada ramai orang, ramai performers. Saya ni ada bercita-cita lah, kononnya lah, bercita-cita nak belajar main skateboard masa saya kecil dulu, kononnya.
Masa kita muda-muda, you know, we played PlayStation dan antara game kegemaran saya adalah Tony Hawk Pro Skater, Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2. Dan bila kita orang pergi Venice Beach, saya nampak skate park yang pernah saya main masa main game dulu dan saya rasa macam wow.
Almost every day lah, setiap hari mesti ada orang akan film kat situ, dia orang akan macam tangkap gambar, tangkap video, all these skateboarders, you know, skating kan. And every time pergi Venice, saya mesti akan duduk dekat tempat apa, skate park tu lama-lama and tengok gambar and tengok diorang beraksi. And saya macam wow, huyo, wow. Itulah. Saya tak boleh skate.
Saya berjaya memandu di US. Banyaklah rintangan dan halangan yang perlu saya lalui. Macam saya nak tengok, tahu-tahu je ada lori sebesar Optimus Prime kat sebelah saya.